All right, I'm doing some testing on this new build, and I can tell you I am having a lot of fun working on this. This will have a Dakota Lithium 10 amp hour battery inside. Right now I've got the VMAX AGM deep cycle. So I pulled it out here to the back patio and using that system, you know, with solar panels to charge it up. And I'll show you real close what I got going on here. You know, a lot of guys use these for their kayaks when they're out fishing. Use it to power their fish finder and charge their phone and yakety schmackety. So this is a Parts Express speaker terminal cup. Good for 12 gauge wire, about 15 amps or so. Toduc SAE 2 pin, so you can use your Battery Tender Jr. trickle charger to maintain the battery. Very lightweight. Went a little crazy with the LED marker lights. This is a solid right now with this DPDT switch. And once I get my Stoppler Wigwagger 240 in, which is delayed in Dallas, I will wire it in, so in one position it'll be solid, in the other position it'll be wigwagging for emergencies. That's your no kidding 12 volt cigarette lighter socket, and that's a no kidding power socket, two different things. So you can use a traditional cigarette lighter in there to light your smokes. Inside here is where the battery and everything is. This is where the lithium goes on those F2 terminals. And this is the battery I'm going to be putting in there. Should be in Tuesday of next week. Blue Sea Systems DualBus, which you unplug there and that pulls up so you have access to the battery so you can remove it. Ease of maintenance, you know? Watertight. You know, a lot of guys put doodads and knickknacks on the top. Nah. Keep it really just like that. All right, this is it done. Next week I'll have another progress report on this unit, and what I want to show you here is a parts list for this build. And just hit pause and you can take a look at what I put in here. All right guys, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.